right. Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us for the latest Star Wars news. And we call this Salacious Crumbs. Really fast, I have a quick question for Mr. Boss. Can we blame the weasels for your bad jokes?
No.
Okay.
That is pure me.
All right. So we usually start Good Morning Multiverse with events. So let's do the same thing here. The Farpoint Convention in Baltimore has announced the late edition of another guest, Shannon McRandall, who will be attending this year. You may know her as the original live-action Mara Jade. Prior to 1998, only illustrations of the character were used in marketing and licensing. But then Lucasfilm decided to cast a live-action model as the likeness for the character for a card game published by Decipher. In 2013, she was diagnosed with ankylosing spondylitis, a type of arthritis that causes inflammation of the spine. And she's also a cancer survivor. So to see her out and about is a treat. She'll be at the Farpoint Saturday and Sunday selling memorabilia from her personal collection. Now, we've been reporting that a new live-action Star Wars show aimed towards a younger crowd is set to begin filming this summer. Now we hear from Discussing Film that John Watts is rumored to be in talks to direct at least one episode and that Jon Favreau will be executive producing. Any more episodes on Watts depends on Watts' future schedule. With the success of Spider-Man No Way Home, currently he's set on board to direct Fantastic Four, produce Final Destination 6, and write and direct a new untitled thriller for Apple TV Plus starring George Clooney and Brad Pitt. Now, rumors are starting to grow based on a recent interview that Ian McDiarmid did with Hugh Montgomery from Metro. He was asked about his thoughts on the Emperor being killed off again and if it was truly the end of him this time. McDiarmid responded that for now he has to accept it. Thanks to his ungrateful granddaughter, his annihilation is finally final. However, he did go on to say this. But of course, Darth Vader is back in the new Obi-Wan Kenobi TV series, so I suppose it's not impossible that one day his mentor might be discovered once again sulking in the shadows. So does this tease mean that we may see him at some point in Kenobi lurking behind Vader? I guess we're just going to have to wait till the show debuts on May 25th. And we have a cover reveal for the Kenobi young adult novel Padawan by Kirsten White. This is in stores July 26th, with a tale of young Obi-Wan getting a little restless under his tutelage of his master, Qui-Gon. And so he goes off on his own, encountering some free-spirited teens who offer him a glimpse of what life could have been. But something isn't quite right. StarWars.com sat down and talked with White about the book, and we'll have a link to that interview in our notes. Now we're going to go. Now we're going to get into some potential spoiler territory here. So if you want to tune out for a minute and pop back in, go ahead. Last week we discussed the premise of Kenobi rescuing a kidnapped 10-year-old Leia. This week, Making Star Wars brings a little bit more insight to that storyline. The assumption is that the Grand Inquisitor is hunting Obi-Wan, but it's been pointed out that old Ben's pretty good at sneaking around without getting caught. Remember, it has been 10 years since he went into hiding after Order 66. Apparently, what's happened is a young Jedi straggler named Nari comes to Tatooine looking for Kenobi, seeking refuge and restoring the Jedi Order. Nari is obsessed with the message Kenobi sent when Order 66 happened. However, since Nari doesn't know the larger mission for the older Jedi, his search puts everything into jeopardy. When the Inquisitors arrive, Uncle Owen senses the trouble that the old Jedi has brought, and wanting to keep young Luke safe, he fights with Kenobi. Now, understanding that leaving Tatooine might be better for the young Skywalker, the opportunity to help Senator Organa find Leia is kind of perfect. Again, this is rumor, so take it with a grain of salt, but Making Star Wars has been pretty good in the past. We'll just have to wait and see. And LRM Online is reporting a rumor that there's not one, but two confrontations between Obi-Wan and Darth Vader. Just don't kill the messenger here. Another rumor on the action figure side of things. Yakface.com is reporting that they've heard Hasbro may be bringing back the Shae Vizsla figure from the Old Republic era. Apparently, this figure is pulling in some high aftermarket prices. This particular figure we're showing you here is on eBay right now for $320. And congratulations are in order for Boba Fett's Starship set number 75312 from LEGO. It won Toy of the Year from the Toy Foundation, which is dubbed the Oscars of the toy industry. Nominations were announced last November, and the judges, which are made up of toy retailers, consumers, media, and members of the Toy Association, took 2 months to deliberate before the winners were announced on February 18th. There are 18 categories, and LEGO took the top place in 8 of them, which included the Bounty Hunter's ship for Playset of the Year. The category is for toys that are designed to work together to enact some action or include characters and role-playing. And it's finally official. LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga has gone gold, which basically means the development for the game is done and a release date is set in stone. The announcement was made by the official LEGO Star Wars game Twitter account, while also congratulating the team that had been working on the game. And this will be released on April 5th, 2022 for PC, PlayStation 5, PlayStation 4, Xbox Series XS, Xbox One, and the Nintendo Switch. Now, just because the Clone Wars are finished doesn't mean you can't continue to enjoy the series. Titan Magazines is releasing Star Wars The Clone Wars, the official collector's edition. This new hardback magazine features behind-the-scenes information and interviews about the series and in-depth guides to every single episode of The Clone Wars. This beauty is currently available for pre-order for $22.49 and will be released on March 29th. Dark Horse Comics will be releasing an omnibus of Rebels mini comics on July 6, 2022. Number 1 through 35, number 37, and number 39 were originally released in Star Wars Rebels magazine from 2015 and 2017, and number 1 through 4 in Star Wars Rebels animation magazine. Authors include Jeremy Barlow, Alec Worley, and Martin Fisher, with art from Robert Molesworth, Ingo Romling, Ava Witterman, Rory Coleman, and Cosmo White. Now, even though Rebels magazine stopped publishing in the U.S. after October 2016, it continued in Germany until December of 2017 before it became Rebels Animation Magazine. So the collection will probably include some comics that have actually never been published here in the United States. This is the first collection from Dark Horse Star Wars since announcing the collaboration between the comic publisher Lucasfilm and Disney World Publishing. This week's release announcement from Denuo Novo is the Star Wars The Force Awakens First Order Stormtrooper Standard Kit. The Build-It-Yourself kit allows you to customize to your needs. It's designed to fit a 5'8" to 6' tall person, armor made of UV-protected white ABS plastic, cloth joint gaskets for easy mobility, and a belt with functioning storage pouches. Now, mind you, this is only the armor, so the gloves, boot, neck seal, and helmet are not included. Now, I'm too short for this. However, Mr. Boss's birthday is next week, so I could pre-order this, and it would only set us back $700, with a shipping date in the second quarter of 2022. All right. So, the Star Wars Galactic Star Cruiser. It is set to set sail on its maiden voyage March 1st, but this week it was open for the press to come in and take a look at it. Here is some of what they saw and experienced on the Halcyon. We know you can choose between the dark or the light side for your journey, but every action that you take will determine what your own personal adventure is going to be. Talking to one character could lead you on a rescue mission, while the other may send you to story time with another character. You track these interactions through the Play Disney Parks mobile app, which will track and combine all your experiences and allow you to move forward on certain paths. You can easily have a completely different experience than someone else who is in your group. To board the ship, they use transport pods, which is similar to the one that is featured in the Rise of Resistance ride. Guests head into a room with small windows that show the outside changing from planet to space and finally the ship. Now, cabins are similar to those that you find on cruise ships. They are not huge, but who's going to spend a lot of time in their room anyway on this voyage? Doors will open side to side, so sliding instead of swinging open. They have berths or bunks that are built into the walls, chairs and tables that pull out from the walls, animated windows, and a droid. Yeah, a droid. D309 is an AI that interacts with guests. She will remember your name, things you've told her, and offer you advice throughout your experience. She will also talk about the experiences guests have on their own personal storylines. So no two room droids will be the same since everybody is on a different path. The Star Cruiser is tied to every Star Wars era. The design of the ship is from the High Republic, with display of relics from the royal families that do include Han and Leia. And there are plenty of characters, new and old, sprinkled about. And lastly, the Galactic Star Cruiser also ties in the experiences guests can have at Galaxy's Edge, which adds more context and to the narrative for the park and its rides. So, is this enough for you to spend your hard-earned credits for that two-night stay? As more details are released, we will be watching to see how those reservation numbers hold out. Maybe there's going to be less cancellations now that guests have a better idea of what their experience is going to be that they are paying for. And those are your Salacious Crumbs for this week. Don't forget, Salacious Crumbs is on Facebook and Instagram. And make sure you hit that like button, and we will have more for you next week.
Copyright 2022 by Flaming Dog Media, LLC. All rights reserved. No portion of this program may be retransmitted without the express written consent of Flaming Dog Media. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.